the power to understand the truth, the power to go behind the truth is the second thing, power to stick. Third thing, energy to let go. This is the real thing. In this ultimate gambling, you can be sure of one thing. This is the major difference between gambling and this ultimate gambling. In this ultimate gambling, you will never lose anything. You will only gain. That is the greatness of this gambling. In this gambling, you will gain only ultimately. You will never lose anything. But to start, to walk, to let go, you need courage. Let go means you will come upon a space, you will come upon a time when the seed dies to become a tree. You will come upon that moment. When the seed dies to become a tree, it has got a tremendous insecurity. Will I really become a tree? It has got a terrible fear to die as a seed. But unless seed dies as a seed, unless seed opens up, tree can never happen. That is why they call Nirvana the last nightmare. It is the last nightmare. It is a wild dream you can have. Now, understand one thing. How you come out of your dreams? If the dream is too wild, automatically you wake up. You come to the wakeful state. If you see a lion in the dream, the next moment, you are out. You wake up. Same way, if you see some wild things in the life, you wake up to the ultimate enlightenment. So, enlightenment happens when a sudden shock happens also. Awareness and sudden shock, if both happens to you, you wake up from the dream state. That's why in Zen monasteries there are strange techniques to make a man enlightened. Once a master was walking in the third floor of his building, enlightened master. One disciple came to him, asked, "Master, I want enlightenment." Master didn't answer, he was just walking. Again the disciple was following, but very sincere fellow, sincere disciple. When they were walking near the parapet wall, again the disciple asked, "Master, please give me enlightenment." Suddenly the master turned and pushed him from the third floor. Just pushed him. But the disciple has got so much of love and the trust on the master. Even at the time of falling, when he does, there must be something good. Totally relaxed, calm, cool. He is just falling, but his being is not at all shaken. The story says, not story, it's actually incident happened. The story says, his body fell, but never his being. When he fell like a flower and got up just to dance. Of course, you may think, how can this be fact? How can a man fall from the third floor and just get up to dance? But there is one modern research which says, which proves this is possible. It says, your heaviness only makes damage in your system. If you don't have heaviness, even if you fall, your body never resists the nature. They have worked on the kids. See, when the kids fall, they don't get hurt much. Much, they don't get the injury, the damage is very less. And through so many things they worked, finally they say, when you fall in the river, you just go deep. After you die, your dead body floats, but your dead body is much heavier than your living body. Why? Living persons, they get drowned, but the dead body floats. And once you are dead, the whole body is filled with water. That's one more thing. It becomes more heavy and filled with water, but dead body floats, living beings are drowning. Why? From this research, they prove your ego, your solidness only is the main reason for the damage caused. The damage is caused more because of your ego and solidness. There was a great dancer, forgot his name. At one moment of his whirling, Sufi whirling dancer. At one moment of his dance, he used to just fly from the sky and used to roll on the sky and land. When he lands, never he was hurt. And this flying yoga, flying yogis, there are a group of meditators who practice this levitation, flying yoga. Even the scientific studies are done on the levitators. I read a magazine, an article in Time magazine, August 2003. If you see, you can see the article, a scientific research on levitation. They prove the egolessness can levitate your body. If you can fall without ego, body never gets hurt. This man, when he was pushed from the third floor, the trust and the courage to stake the whole thing, in one moment he became enlightened. People asked me, Swamiji, why don't you also give enlightenment like that to us? I told them, the disciple is really, disciple was trusting the master totally. First of all, people don't have trust. Second thing, lawsuits. But one thing, with masters, never failure happens. That is the beauty. This is the system, foolproof system. Never failure happens. One more small story. There was some disciple. He's a Naga tradition. Naga means the Vedantic tradition. He's the disciple of Vedantic tradition. The master used to every day give this course. The master has got some special ways of speaking, special accent and special ways of moving the hands. The disciple, by and by, seeing the master, he just thought only, let me imitate the master. And he used to just stand backside the disciple, master, and imitate. As master does the whole thing, he used to imitate. And master also knows, let this guy do. But that guy has got so much of love and devotion for the master, master never minds that. One day when he was imitating, just behind the master, he was standing and imitating the master, as master does. Naga sannyasis used to keep a big sword with them always. Suddenly he took that sword and cut the hand of the disciple. Just he cut the finger, one finger of the disciple. Again, the disciple was having so much of trust and devotion for the master, he thought, when he does, it must be good. Now you can always think, oh, when Swami does, it is good. At that moment, that is a grand thing, that is a real thing. And the story says, his finger fell along with his ego. The moment he became enlightened. And the next day, disciples all asked him. The disciples took this disciple and they did all the medical first aid, everything. He became all right. Next day they asked him, all right, master, he became enlightened, that's great. But he lost his finger and he has to undergo that pain and we have to do all these things. What do you say about that? Master said, for the sake of enlightenment, people work lives after lives. Losing one finger is nothing wrong, leave it. People who are ready to put the things at stake only are real gamblers. Only they are the courageous one. Only they are the qualified one to play this ultimate game. To play this ultimate game. Meditation does not mean you will just change your routine half an hour extra. Just you will change half an hour of your routine. No. It means you will change your whole quality of your routine. Meditation has nothing to do with the quantity of your routine. It has got quality of your routine. If you take up the meditation, whole life will change. Whole understanding will change. Whole life will become new. That is what is real meditation. When you meditate, you gamble your whole life. You put your whole life at stake. Only then the transformation can happen. If you put 10%, you will get only 10%. If you put the whole, then only you can have holy. If you put your whole, then only you can become holy. The power to state the things is what is real power or second step for ultimate gambling. Energy to let go. Energy to allow the transformation happen. So I was telling you, the sea will always undergo a terrible fear, insecure feeling. I am dying, will I really become tree? That fear will be there. You have to undergo that fear. You have to let go that fear. Only then the transformation is possible. The energy to let go. Only then the transformation is possible. In Christian theology, there is a beautiful word, dark night of the soul. They say this last moment, the last nightmare, nirvana, the last nightmare. What Buddhists say as the last nightmare, Christian theology, Christian mystics say, it's a dark night of the soul. There will be one moment, your whole ego will be just dying. Your whole ego will be just dying. And you have to let go the past to die. Enlightenment never happens as a continuity. It happens as a new birth. Never think, as on you, you will have a crown. Enlightenment is never like a crown. You can be as you are, just have one more crown. No. It is a total new birth. What Christians call as a dark night of the soul, what Buddhists call as the last nightmare, Hindus call Vishada. In Bhagavad Gita, the first chapter is Arjuna Vishada Yoga. Arjuna was totally confused, totally depressed, do not know what to do, where to go. He was facing the dark night of the soul. he was facing a total depression, but he was ready to let go and follow the Krishna. Whenever you are in confusion, confusion means dilemma, whether to do this or do that. When you are in dilemma, whatever decision you take, the dilemma will continue. If you take this and proceed, if I would have taken that, all these things would have happened. If you take this and proceed, again, if I would have taken that, all these things would have happened. Whenever you take choice from dilemma, any decision, again the hangover of dilemma continues. When a master guides you, you must be ready to drop the dilemma and follow behind it. Go behind it. Arjuna had the courage. That is why Krishna could give the enlightenment to him, the Vishwarupa Darshana to him. The power to let go, the energy to let go, energy to allow the dark night or the nightmare to happen to you. Even at the time of nightmare, if you have the trust on the master, the trust on the energy, only then the ultimate gain can happen to you. There was a master, George Gurdjieff. He used to practice strange techniques to make people enlightened. He had a big water stream inside his ashram. Both sides of the river is his ashram, a big river. He had a strange technique. Whenever he shouts stop, whomsoever doing whatever work inside the ashram, they should stop as they are and sit there still and meditate. You may be doing some work in kitchen, but you should drop and sit and meditate. You may be in the bathroom, you should drop and sit and meditate. Whenever he shouts stop, immediately you should enter into meditation. He will release the special energy to touch everybody. One day, some three disciples were working on the river. He shouted stop, and all the three sat and started meditating. Suddenly, unfortunately, the flood started coming. At that moment, flood started coming. First disciple, as soon as the disciple felt the flood is coming, oh, flood is coming. Let me get up. He got up and went away. Second man, till the water came to his neck level, he was sitting. Then he thought, I think master may not be knowing the flood is coming. Better let me escape and save myself. Ran away. Third fellow, just he was sitting. The story says, not only he, his ego is also drowned. And new being floated. When he was floating, he was new being. The trust to undergo the unknown space. Enlightenment or meditation is more or less like a walking into the forest with your eyes tied. That is why in meditation I tie your eyes. It is walking just like eyes tied. You have only one hold, the master's hand or the god's feet. Holding that energy to let go, energy to accept the new thing which is going to happen in your life, energy to transcend the fear of losing your old personality. Whenever you deeply meditate, you will see your old personality slowly withering away. Your old desires are withering away. Your old thinking is withering away. In your life itself, something new starts happening. something new starts flowering. Your understanding is changing. Your life is changing. Your thinking style is changing. Your working method is changing. Everything is totally changing. So if you have power, energy to let go, to let the things change, you have the third quality to play this ultimate.